For me, it's been an ongoing journey, actually, to find language that captures what I think is the essence of spirituality, and in a way that's inclusive rather than exclusive. So when I think, or when I use the word spirituality, I often think about meaning and purpose, and how living with a sense of meaning or purpose enables us to live well, and I would say die well as well. So thinking about meaning and purpose, I often think of the word connection or connectedness as kind of the ways that we find meaning and purpose, and I would say a connectedness with self, connectedness with others, and so our fellow human beings, and then a sense of a connectedness with something greater than, and it could be other with a capital O, it might be a sense of a transcendent being, within faith or religious traditions, a sense of God. For some folks, it's a sense of nature, but something that goes beyond our humanness. So that's probably the definition that I've learned to cherish and use in my own work. A part of what people identify as they face end of life, and certainly the research and the literature would affirm that, yes, we've learned through time spent with people who are facing end of life that they would identify spiritual needs as a part of what they find to be important. And sometimes people talk about the opportunity at the end of life as our physical being diminishes. It's actually our spirituality that for some folks flourishes and becomes much more a focus of our being. We're often, as disease advances, we're less able to be a human doing and are really left with that opportunity to focus on being a human being. And so I think spirituality and who we are at our core becomes much more important.